Blackstone Publishing presents The Life-Giving Parent, Giving Your Child a Life Worth Living for Christ by Clay and Sally Clarkson. This book is read by James Anderson Foster, a member of SAG-AFTRA, and Anne Richardson. We dedicate this book to our four wonderful children. We gave you a life worth living for Christ, and you've made our lives worth living. May the life of God you found in our life-giving home be the life that fills your own. Foreword, Sally. Summer evenings in Colorado often find us on our back deck as the sun sets behind the foothills of the Rockies. There's something about a cool breeze and gently swaying pine trees that is both rejuvenating and calming at the same time. Dare I say that it feels life-giving? If so, then perhaps it pictures just a little what I hope our children have found in the life of our home and in the gentle breeze of the life of God blowing through it. Every August, near our wedding anniversary, we gather with our children for our annual family day. After a full day of traditional activities, we typically end up sitting around the table on the deck, sipping a variety of beverages and enjoying those life-giving mountain breezes. We joke and jest, converse and contend, and reminisce and remember. With four thoughtful and opinionated millennial children, there is never, ever a let-up in the discussion. It's a Clarkson family moment. After our last family day, when Clay and I had some time to be alone, we talked about that table full of blessing and destiny. Solomon was certainly right when he said in Psalm 127 that children are a gift of the Lord. Our children have been God's gift to us in more ways than we can describe, and they will be God's gift to the world through us in ways we have yet to know, or perhaps we'll never know while we're still around. As we thought back together about each child around that table, we realized that in the same way we tried to give life to them in our home while they were growing up, they have given more life to us than we can measure. Life-giving has been a two-way path. After 33 years of parenting, our four delightful children are all grown and out of the house now, except when they're not. As much as we miss them, it means Clay and I have reached that pivotal parental point of being able to look back and reflect on our parenting journey, all the challenges, choices, chuckles, and changes. Since we are still involved parents to our grown children, we look back not so much with nostalgia as with contemplation. What did we do right? Where did we go wrong? What would we do differently if we could? What have we learned? What can we share with those who come behind us, whether our own children or new generations of parents? This book arose out of discussions like those. As we talked about the stories and our years of parenting together, we understood that we, like most parents, had little conception when we started the journey, what we were doing, and even less what it would require of us. We agreed that parenting was the best of all the ministry we've done in our lives, but we had no idea what that investment in our children would cost us, physically, emotionally, spiritually, and financially. It is only now that we can begin to observe the dividends. Whatever life-giving we did is now paying out in the rich life of faith we see in each of our children. However, did I also mention the speed bumps, potholes, blind curves, and other road hazards we encountered along the path of parenting? It was not a smooth ride. After all, every Christian family, ours included, is inhabited by sinful, selfish human beings called parents and children. The idea that Christian parenting should be a purely joyful journey through life is misguided at best and an illusion at worst. And yet, despite our own immaturities and weaknesses, We made it through with no casualties and with faith intact. We're all stronger than when we started. But Christian parenting is more than just getting from one point to another by faith. We know intuitively we're made for something more than just crossing the finish line. We're made to be part of God's epic story of creation, the story He is writing, not only for all of life, but for each of our lives. As life-giving parents, one of our most important tasks has been to help our children discover themselves in the story God is writing, to find their places in the unfolding tale of God's grand purpose and plan, and to know that we are all, as a family, in that story together. As I've partnered with Clay in that bigger picture, it has been my privilege to do my best to be a godly mother to our children, to nurture their faith through my love, grace, discipleship, encouragement, instruction, and inspiration. I have found purpose and meaning in trying to be the kind of mother I believe was in God's heart at creation, a life-giving mother, one who brings the life of God to my children. I won't pretend it was always a wonderful journey with no difficulties, but the blessings far outweigh the burdens as I see now the influences of my life on each of my children. They are, as God promised, the blessings. For 20 years, I taught and encouraged Christian mothers in more than 60 Mom Heart conferences to become that kind of mother after God's heart. And there was one question that came up over and over after every event. Does Clay have a book for dads about what you're teaching that I can give to my husband? As a gifted teacher and seminary graduate, Clay always wanted to get to that book, but events and ministry administration would never allow enough time to write it. Now that we've retired from regular conference ministry, Clay has finally been able to carve out enough time to think about this book and write it. The life-giving parent is the answer to that question asked by so many moms. I had already written The Life-Giving Home with our daughter Sarah and The Life-Giving Table, so when Clay suggested the idea of The Life-Giving Parent, I was thrilled. It would not only complete a life-giving trilogy, but would also finally provide the book that all those moms for so many years had been asking for, and not just for their husbands, but for themselves as well. It pulls together many of the messages we've taught through the years.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.